There we go. Sorry about that. That took a little bit longer to get started up than anticipated. This controller. There we go. Welcome in, everybody. Hope you are all doing well. No, wrong way. There we go. Yeah, a little bit late on the uptake right there. Hello there, Chicken Man Roost. Nah, it's not 12:30 yet. There we go. Hello there, Chloe. Welcome in. So, actually, since we seem to have a lot of people here right now, let's do an open lobby for everyone for the first one. Normally, we go solo or with randos for the first match, but since we've got a lot of people here, let's see if we can get a group for this one. But how is everybody doing today? Hope you are all doing delightful. I'm doing very well. Almost laughing, man. Hello there, Pokemon Go guy. Welcome in. Hello there, Flick. Hello there, Cookie. Hello there, Roost. Kayla. Pokemon Go guy. Welcome in, everybody. Hope you're all doing well. This morning, evening, afternoon, or night, depending on where you are in the world. But yeah, we are a little bit late. But better late than never, I guess you could say. But yeah, no, today's gonna be good. I got some plans. After this, of course, gonna get some more recording done for the Godzilla videos and finish planning for my Draft League match. Had a power cut yesterday. What do you mean by power cut? Like your power went out yesterday? That's not good. Yeah, let's go and see. So let's go check out our matchups for the IBL, not UNPL. Let's go check out what our matches are in the meantime while people pop in. So we know week 5 I'm against DJS. He worries me. He's the one that sniped some of my good picks. Week 6 I fight Nova. Let's see what Nova's lineup is. Let's see what Nova's packing. Ah, the Bermuda Kecleon. Oh boy, Cinderachi. Hey, Cinderachi, Galarian Slowking. Ah, I gotta fight Metagross week 6. It's not gonna be fun. I'm fully expecting Nova to bring Metagross to face me just as a psychological tactic. Psychological warfare. Glastrier, Terra Glastrier with Terra Electric. You know, respect that. That makes sense. Gliscor. I've got things for Gliscor. I've got countermeasures for Gliscor. Hisuian Samurott. Does Hisuian Samurott get upper hand? Does Hammerott learn upper hand, or does it not learn upper hand? I can never remember what things and don't learn upper hand. I mean, so long as I've got Volcanion, I should be perfectly fine against Glastrier. Well, they'd probably have to go Terra Electric for Glastrier. That's kind of the good thing about having Volcanion. It basically forces a lot of things very specific, because it's such an awkward typing. It's such a obnoxious typing within an ability. Alright, I guess we're gonna go on solo for the first pathing of Tornado Face. Yeah, the good thing is with Tornadus being at the top, it's a power. Ah, power outage. I'm starting to build stairs while I watch. I'm assuming stairs in Minecraft, right? Stairs in Minecraft, right? Oh, yes, Jolteon. Fantastic. Yeah, so long as we get, like, an electric type or a rock type right at the start, like a decent electric type or a rock type right at the start, we beat this thing. Ooh, Rotom. Oh, I see Lycanroc Dusk. Not Dusk, Lycanroc Midnight Form. This is ideal. Yeah, because I need that, and then we go, yeah, I mean, yeah, and that's ideal. Hello there, Terra Mars. I'm doing well. I'm doing very, very well. I'm just saying hi, going to enjoy some Wendy's fun. I do enjoy Wendy's myself. Let's see. Upper hand. I forget what learns upper hand as a move, and I'm curious to see what it gets. Upper hand. Pokemon. But yeah, the day's been going quite good so far. I'm not even gonna use Dynamax. I don't need the Dynamax here. Yeah, I don't even need the Dynamax here. I mean, yeah, it would help more damage from Throat Chop, but it's like the extra animation time just isn't worth it. Yeah, that's the thing about Dynamaxing. In a lot of cases, it's not as worth it. I hope I get the shiny as well. In a lot of cases, it isn't really worth it to Dynamax against the regular non-legendary Pokemon, purely because it's just the amount of time it takes for the Dynamax to go through. Just, it doesn't worth, like, unless it is something very, very specific where, you know, you need debuffs in order to handle it, or, you know, something like that. You know, say, like, you've got no super effective or even no neutral moves, but you've got, like, a Dark or a Ghost move that has, like, a decreasing effect. That's good to go for it, because then you need the debuff. But, I mean, or, you know, maybe you're fighting a Torkoal and you have a bunch of water types, but it immediately sets up Sun, you need the Rain. If I'm not typing in chat anymore. Okay. But yeah, no, there's a few times it's really not as worth it to go for the Dynamax than the regular Mook Pokemon. Upper Hand. What learns Upper Hand? So is it priority moves from abilities as well? Okay, yes, it does work against abilities that give priority moves. Okay. So it was right, it does affect Gale Wings and Prankster. Really, Raichu learns Upper Hand. Poliwrath. Yeah, Apom makes sense to learn Upper Hand. That makes sense. That math checks out. Hariyama makes sense. Infernape, interesting. Hisuian Samurott does learn Upper Hand. Alright. I'm glad I checked that. I'm gonna need to watch out for that against Rillaboom. The Boom. Mimikyu. Mimikyu shouldn't really be that big of an issue. Yeah, we're gonna go for that because I could use a Lycanroc Midnight Form shiny. Diplin. Ah, Terra Diplin. Interesting. Grass, Poison, and Fairy Terra types. Is it Volcanion insanely weak to ground? Not really. Volcanion is water fire. Which means it absolutely demolishes rock types and absolutely demolishes ground types. That's the reason why Volcanion's got such a great typing. Is it has a fantastic weakness coverage. Because, yes, it is weak to rock and it is weak to ground. But a lot of ground and rock moves are physical. It has 120 physical defense. And a lot of rock and ground types tend to be quite slow. Where they also don't have a lot of special defense. It is a special attacker. And they are generally very weak to water. And it's a water type. That's kind of the reason why the only viable, quote-unquote, weakness against it is electric. Where, you know, there are ground type, there are selected ground and rock types that can do well against Volcanion, but it's select ground and rock types. It's not the vast majority of them. Electric types can do a little bit better against it, but even then, like, that's targeting its lower special defense. Got up to 1,000 counters, day, almost 1,000. Yikes, that's going to be half. Yeah, Volcanion has no 4x weaknesses. Volcanion is only a standard weakness to 3 typings, electric, rock, and ground. Yes, electric, rock, and ground. It has no quad weakness. You might be thinking of Heatran that has a 4x weakness to ground. Yeah, you might be thinking of Heatran. Doing good today? Good. Glad you didn't wait. I don't know how you've been able to go that long on your shiny hunt for that Magikarp and still have not found the shiny. Have you found other shinies along the way that just weren't the Magikarp? Because, like, I mean, I've seen people go pretty bad on odds for things. But I don't think I've ever heard of anyone going that far into the odds. I assume Volcanion is banned in competitive because it's broken. No, Volcanion is banned in VGC because it's a mythical. Mythicals are flat banned in VGC. Yeah, that... A lot of mythicals do tend to be broken, but they're banned for an entirely separate reason. And that's, it's just because of limited availability. Cypress meta, Cypress's hunt for Geodude. Flick, we're in a solo thing. We're in a solo DA for the first battle. There's no one joining this one. What was Cypress's hunt again? I don't remember how long that was. Like, you gotta remember, I don't know the others as well as you do, Roost. I don't know the others as well as you do. We can go Krim. Yeah, again. Yeah, and the first Dynamax adventure of every stream is a solo DA. Still ongoing over 120. So, no phases on that so far. What game is he hunting in? Because, like, I think Pokemon Go guy is hunting in, I think, like, Sword or Shield or something. Is Cypress hunting in, like, Gen 4 or something? I think. If we can end, if we can beat this thing this turn, that would be freaking ideal. So I can instantly turn one Dynamax against the Volcanion. Come on, Boldor! Come on, Boldor, you can do this! I just need this Boldor to land Stone Edge. Yes! We get the first turn Dynamax against the Tornado Face. Oh, this is easy. This is just a game end right there. Okay. Yeah, hunting and sword, but man, if I get the shiny, I'm never playing this one again. Yeah, he's got, I'm assuming, shiny charm going for him in Pokemon Go, in Sword and Shield. So I think he's got, like six times the odds. Like, six times better odds. Which, I mean, again, that's not as surprising. That is only for Cypress. What is that? 15 times odds? Like, that's... It's bad that it's 15 times odds. But I wouldn't say it is beyond the scope of possibility. For, you know, something to go 15 times odds. Again, my hunt for Shark... Oh, Jonah Syndrome. Okay. There's a Starman waiting in the sky. I would love to get a Starman. I would love that. Also, if you guys haven't done so already, don't forget to leave a like on the stream. And subscribe for more if you haven't done so already. Yeah, Star. I'm gonna play Kirby more at some point. I'm gonna play that at some point. But no, it's gonna be good. It's gonna be great. I've got plans. But yeah, let's go check the rest of our matchups for the IBL. So, we're going up against... Yeah, Nova is going to be an interesting fight. Nova's going to be an interesting fight. Yeah. Oh yeah, Rotom Frost with Terra Ice. I like that. Kind of surprised they went triple Terra Fairy for everything. But I guess it does make sense on Rotom Frost. Purely down to the potential... fighting weakness. Terra Ice, though, does make sense. You can actually use Terra Blast Ice and not need to rely on Blizzard. It's a good call. Terra Fire. Terra Fire kind of also goes hand in hand with that. But then again, that's still weakness to Rock. I guess it would be for Terra Blast Fire to beat. Well, then again, what would that be for? Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, I guess it would be like to blast through Steel types? That could be problematic? I would like to know what the underlying mental calculus was for that team composition. I'm 100% confident Superman Legacy is gonna have that song. What's Superman Legacy? What is Superman Legacy? Not sure. Is that like a new Superman movie? Well, lost to Tornado Face. Yeah. Tornadus is a weirdly difficult Dynamax adventure only because it's so freaking fast and a lot of spread moves. But no shiny No shiny. No shiny Cremorant. Now we're going to be opening up the DAs for viewers. If you would like to pop in, feel free to join. Link code is 1928-3746. Oh! Oh, the guy who made Guardians of the Galaxy is going to make it. Interesting. So is this going to be like the start of the new DC extended universe? Because I know that they kind of like destroyed the entire DCEU. Like, it's over. There's no point in continuing it. So that could be like the new point. Ah. So are they just going to make standalone DC superhero films from now on? Which I think is the smart call. Like, they need to... It is starting this year. Ah. Like, what DC needs to go back to making, like, standalone superhero movies, figure out what they're going to do, then maybe try and connect them all into one big universe. Because, like, all DC's got to do is make, like, one or two more good DC movies, and people are going to go over to DC from Marvel. Because, like, Marvel's been floundering. And there's more than a few things that people are not satisfied when it comes to Marvel lately. Granted, depending on how Deadpool and Wolverine goes, that will decide things. Also, when the freak is that coming out? Because I know that they pushed that back. Oh yeah, Hilligan gets upper hand. Didn't they use Flash to reset the universe like people usually do? No, I think they just flat out ended it. Like, meta-contextually, it's over. They're not continuing it. They might have done that, but I did not see the Flash movie. Hello there, Jojo. Hello there, Jojo. Yes, Deadpool and Wolverine. When is that coming out? I'm pretty sure it was supposed to come out in, like, what, February or something? Well, no, they didn't recast Batman. They brought back a previous Batman. Ah, it's coming out in July. Yeah, apparently it was, like, what, supposed to be... Yeah, they was originally supposed to be scheduled earlier, and then they like, pushed it back. You think you'll get wiped out by Flashborn? I mean, really, they did. I thought they had meta-contextually just got rid of it. All right. Well, it's a different Batman from the one we saw in the DCU, so it's kind of... Fair enough. I mean, I feel like that's... I mean, again, I feel like it's more like a returning actor, but yeah, I can see your point on that. I can see that. Again, you guys haven't done so already. Don't forget to subscribe for more. Leave a like. I am going to go for Glalie. None of these are good options. I guess the least bad is Hitmonchan. Just because it has a very good special defense, comparatively. I don't know why they changed Thomas Wayne to Bruce Wayne to be here. Oh, Kingler actually is very good because wide guard. Actually very good because of that wide guard. We need to rely on Martin. I'm scared. I am very, very scared. Okay, I see some electric types. I see electric. That's good. That electric type is Dedenne. All right. Kayla, I want you to switch out the Hitmonchan for the Dedenne. I'm not complaining. You're in the classic Batman. Yeah, very good. Very, very good. Don't support privacy. Yeah, exactly. Looking forward to the true DCU evolutions. Yeah, he does good with a lot of his movies. Like, Guardians of the Galaxy, fantastic. But the blank squad, because you can't really say that word without, you know, getting docked into oblivion. That was actually okay. That was fairly good. Yeah, no, it's gonna be interesting. The original Flashpoint roles were reversed. Batman as the dad at a young age. Same way his parents died in the main universe, and Martha became the Joker and Thomas became the Batman. Ah, interesting. Yeah, I don't really know too much about DC stuff. I know far more Well, not far more. I know a bit more about Marvel. One grab I had with DC is their catching toy. Yep. Hello there, Zetar. How are you doing? It's been a while. How have you been? Okay, we got a paralysis. Good work, Dura. Actually, what am I doing? I can just use fake tears and have Dura do that. Remember, when it comes to Dynamaxing, we do not need to always Dynamax against the regular Pokemon, unless, like, unless specifically said, do not Dynamax against the regular Pokemon. Again, a lot like with the status moves, just use attacking moves unless otherwise stated. People should have given Aquaman 2 a chance. Yeah, Aquaman... First Aquaman was great. I liked the first Aquaman. I've not seen the second one, but... I'm kind of avoiding movies for a while. Unless their name is Godzilla. Unless it's Godzilla. Godzilla's awesome. I like the second one. Interesting. Very good. Interesting. Well, Aquaman 2 was alright. Interesting. Yeah, the only issue I've heard with it is that they kind of, like, stopped caring about the DC stuff. Hello there, Omar. How you doing? I'm doing well. How you doing? I'm doing well. My thing. Hope everyone is having fun. We are indeed. Yes, despite the lot of yes. Hello, this is Adam. Yes. I would ideally hope we get this shiny today. Like, I just want one of my shiny Draft League Pokemon from Dynamax Adventures. Just want at least one of them. We would Jason Momoa. So was it. Yeah, I mean, I like Jason Momoa. He does great when it comes to movies. Like, I very much enjoyed him in Justice League. I still say the Zack Snyder cut of Justice League was great. You had a feeling that it was going to be switching out. That I had a feeling that was going to happen. Actually, Kayla, switch out for this. Switch out. Actually, no, it's fine. Actually, never mind. Never mind. It's fine. Yeah, it's not great that he did that, but we can still probably recover. I hope Martin switches out the Scyther for this. Because again, AI literally designed to throw in Dynamax Adventures. The AI is nothing but a throwbot.
I love David Pista, but if the recast actually destroyed Jason Momoa, would... Yeah, same!
Same. Hey, guys, Art. Yeah, charge a bug, yeah. Well, I mean, at least it has dig. At least it has dig. There was, like, literally no damage we could have done otherwise. This is a case where Dynamax, the Dynamax, the Kingler. Okay, Omar, thanks.
Next our screen.
Nice. But yeah, no, it's gonna be something. It's gonna be something. I have literally nothing to hit this thing with. I have literally nothing to hit you with. Lemon. Well, then again, if it uses any of its moves as a Dynamax move, I could use Steel Roller. Apple. So I was gonna make a super. No, it's all good, Flick. It's all good. It's all good. Hypothetically. Okay, do I need any requirements? It depends on what draft league you'd want to join. Because the draft leagues I'm a part of, they're all, like, content creator draft leagues. So it's like... I'm glad it did not use Thunder. I'm glad it did not use the Max Electric move. No. There's no real requirements to any draft league. Yeah, no, you can just join any draft league. Each individual draft league has, like, its own requirements, but there's no, like, every draft league requires a standard thing. So it's, you know, draft leagues are, you know, fairly loose with the rules. Jellybug, use dig. Again, if you guys haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe for more. Leave a like. Yeah, there's no specific requirements for any draft leagues. Draft leagues are generally very open things, and each individual draft league has its own requirements. Like the IBL I'm in, it's upload required, but, you know, other than that, it's, you just use the Pokemon you're using in your own, you just have your own team which you can use. No restrictions on items. There's a few move clauses and a few item clauses, but, you know, overall, it's like, there's really no reason. Okay, certain game website, need to go to. Generally, there are, like, specific Discords for it, but no, there's no specific website that's a Pokemon Draft League website. It's kind of a thing where, like, you ask around, like, ask other people who are in them, and they may know one to join, but the only leagues that I know of are ones that are creator-exclusive. Officially say I have shiny female, masculine, and male. Nice! Nice work. I like colors G. And that is a Steel Roller takedown. Get grind away that Misty Terrain. Yeah, Steel Roller could have been a really cool move if it wasn't for the fact it was limited exclusively to terrains being in play. I get why they made it. It was to be a counter to Dynamax terrains, but it doesn't work well. Actually, congratulate you. I congratulate you. Very nice. Again, you guys haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe for more. I nearly failed a male twice. Interesting. Yeah, the way that I did my shiny Basque fish checks is I just had Maridon go around and wipe out everything. And then when it stopped fighting one, I was like, oh, that's the shiny. Favorite lightsaber of time is the youngest fan. That's dark. Gold Dynamo get a small buff. What is the Gold Dynamo's buff? Points required for some of the special weapons have been changed. Oh! Gold Dynamo. Oh, nice! So, wait, what is the Gold Dynamo's special again? I guess we go for this one, because it's easy. Learning Legends. Ah! Legends Abacus! I mean, I'd say that's fairly important. That's Splatoon-related, right? I mean, Splatoon-related right before a Splatfest? I'd say that's important enough. That's important enough. After all, it means a better win condition for us. We have really nothing. Just use Dazzling Gleam on this thing. Just use Dazzling Gleam. Youngling Slayer is diabolical. Again, I would love to see the alternate universe version of Star Wars Revenge of the Sith, where it is all the younglings setting up Home Alone style traps to catch Anakin and the clone troops. I would love to see that. I'm happy. Opened my booster pack today. Got a Mimikyu card. Noise. Yeah. Now this is a case where Dynamax. This is a Dynamax case. Can I time it out? No, you cannot time Roost out for that, Mudkip. You cannot time out Roost. And let's get going. It is time to face this thing. Youngs only need to cover Anakin with Sith. Exactly. Also, but Lego Rescue Helicopter. Cool, is fun. Legos are fun. Steel Spike. I don't think Steel Spike will one-shot this thing. Yeah, no, it has filter. It has a... Yes, Kayla, you're gonna Dynamax against Tornadus. Shiver. More like people simper. No, I mean, you're not incorrect on that. Not incorrect on that. Anakin fails to get the younglings. He's gonna resort to plans. Star Wars. Really looks like a Lugo from Pac-Man Busted. I mean, it's a goalie mask. Yeah, Glalie is literally a frozen-over goalie mask from hockey. Which, if Bibarel and Bidoof didn't exist, it would be the most Canadian Pokemon, because it's literally hockey. Yes. It is literally the hockey Pokemon. That's why its name is Glalie. It's basically coming on goalie. Did somebody say Pac-Man? Oh, the roost signal has been activated. No one switches out. Dang it, I really wanted him to switch out. But it's fine. We're going in full lives. Kingler, just use Wide Guard. Exclusively click Wide Guard, Kingler. Why do I suddenly hear Power Pellet sound? Oh my gosh, I can hear it too. I remember back. Wait. There was a Pac-Man the Animated Series? That's a thing? If it had a theme song, I would be classic Batman theme, but with a banjo accompaniment. Interesting. Wait, there's two of them? Why were there two of them? I'm just confused. Okay, on Disney XD. Okay, that math checks out. Significant confusion. There's one in the 1980s and one in the 2010s. Pretty buff and interesting. Sometimes I worry. Sometimes I worry about the world. It was an old show. The pack is back. And that's why we love Wide Guard. Tornado Face can't really do damage to us. You can't hit us, Tornado Face. What's it like to suck? It sucks to suck, Tornado Face, does it not? Fortunately, Dedenne doesn't really have a high attack power, special attack. But at least Electric Terrain should do damage, remember the theme song. And also with Fake Tears going off, it actually will make it more damage, the snowballing. Get snowballing with a giant thing of ice. The Pillarman theme is fantastic. The Pillarman theme is indeed a bop. Hello there, Declan Travaskio. Welcome in. How are you doing? Welcome in, everybody. Ha, Wide Guard once again blocks the freaking icy wind. It sucks to suck, Tornado Face. It sucks to suck. Again, don't forget to subscribe for more, guys. If you haven't done so already. And leave a like. Also, I don't have Joy-Cons, but my character in Legend of Abacus just walks by itself. That's terrifying. It was a little bit terrifying. I should have gone for Ice Fang right there. That would have actually knocked it out. But I mean, next turn you lose anyway. Right, you have air. Wait, you have. No, it only has three spread moves. Heat Wave, Air Cutter, and Icy Wind, because it doesn't have Bleak Wind Storm. I briefly forgot Bleak Wind Storm did not exist in this game. Now I'm just imagining Dio versus Jotaro with the Benny Hills theme playing. That sounds fun. I'd love to hear that. I don't know that amuses me very good. My game glitched and went straight to the game. Now I pressed A's. That's very scary. Awakened something in the people. Yeah. Better please watch. Please help. Kato is supposed to jet them. I have no idea what that even is, Wilkins. Alright, let's increase our counter for Thunderous by one. One more Thunderous. Another Thunderous bites the dust. Bites the dust, though. No shiny Scyther. No shiny Dedenne. No shiny Mr. Mime, which I'm kind of okay with that, but I still need one anyway. But no shinies across the board. Check that on his last stream. Please don't give us a good Godzilla game on a trashy RPG. I wonder how they would even be able to do Godzilla games going forward. It is indeed Mr. Mime. Alright, let's go again. Dynamax Adventure Lobby opening up. Once again, link code is 19283746. Let's go. Played ranked matches yesterday and just won a Greninja duel with 4 HP. Fun. Oh, you're gonna love the IBL Week 1 matchup. The match ended on literally 1 HP. Speaking of, let's go check out our opponent for Week 7 of the IBL. Dashing Sceptile, Week 7. And then Rose and then Operator. Dashing Sceptile, what does Dashing have? Ah, Dashing is the Seattle Sigalith. Sneasler, Chiyu, Rotom, Wash, Terra, Indeedee, Iron Crown, Landotherian. Okay, that's a little bit scarifying. Hydrapple, Sylveon, Terra Coliface, Terra Jumpluff. All very low tier Terras. Interesting. Interesting. Let's see, what did Dashing, how much did Dashing win by? Wow. He's 6-0'd. Who did he 6-0? Nova got 6-0'd. What's Nova's team again? Okay. Yeah, you know, I can see that. I can see that happening. I can see that. That's scary. Well, at least I fight Dashing Week 7. Maybe I'll make some changes to the lineup by then. Recommend Sonochi no Sadame. Great song. Now that I mentioned it, remember the OST. I mean, a lot of the JoJo music is fantastic. We ain't gonna sugarcoat this. I don't think I want to know what the nightmares that happened were. I don't think I want to know what nightmares that was. Yeah, that's a scary. I mean, Lando is going to be a problem. Oh, right. Set up Lando. That's how he won with a sub Lando. Maybe I'll go Alluring Voice Latias for that. Maybe I go Alluring Voice Latias if I can get that shiny by then. Well, then again, no, I outspeed Blanderous. How much does an Icy Wind... Can I jank this fight? Hello there, Raymond. A copious amounts of alcohol, I believe, helpful for that. Ooh. Lantern absolutely buys that thing. Honestly, Togetic or Basculin are good picks for this, because just click Mystical Fire against Tornadus, and that just debilitates its special attack. Damage calculator. I'm not a big JoJo BA fan, but I can remember, strangely enough, there are some songs in OSTs and Dio's in a sewer, strangely enough? Yes, Dio was in a sewer for one of them. Alright, let's go look for our options. I see some ice types. I see various ice types across the board. Glalie. Alright, so what we're gonna go do is we're gonna go... Yeah, we're gonna go for the Glalie. So we're gonna go... Well, we're not gonna pick up the Glalie. Well, actually, we are gonna pick up the Glalie. So, switch out the Basculin. Actually, what do we do with this? What do we do on this? Yeah, I got really nothing for this thing. Yeah, do not Dynamax the Basculin against the Trevenant. Dynamax the Togetic against the Trevenant and just click, and just keep clicking the Fire-type move. And just keep clicking the Fire move. see what we can do on that. Joseph was the best Joestar. I mean, I like all of them. Okay, fine. Use Trick Room. That does absolutely nothing. Judges Part 3, 2, 6 are my favorite series. I mean, I like most of the parts. There's only one part I don't really care for. I have both of the shinies. Nice, Frogzilla. Welcome in, Frogzilla. Welcome in. Therian. I really would love to know how much Icy Wind does to Lando. There's no way it one-shots it. Wow, 65-78% with Icy Wind with no investment. That's actually surprising. Frozlo, Attack of the Toads. Yes. I want you to switch out Basculin for the Galele. Welcome in. Welcome in, fellow Godzilla fan. So I want you to switch out that for the Glalie. Then we switch out Togetic for the Pelipper. And we have... If you can use fake tears against the Tornadus, I want you to use the fake tears, but then I want the Glalie to Dynamax against the Tornadus so we can get Icy Wind. Well, we get Dynamax Hail. Imaginary Technique, Max Flare. Azumarill sprang up to space! Azumarill goes to space. Yeah, I can't really do any damage to this freaking tree. We cannot damage Groot. It is an unbreakable root. Just keep using Trick Room. Just keep using that move over and over again. It literally does nothing. It does literally nothing to us. Yum. I mean, you get knocked out anyway this turn, Trev. Eat this Thunderbolt. Hurt yourself a confusion, please. I mean, that's fine. You survive! That's all that matters, you survive. That is all that matters is you survive the thing. If you want... Actually, Kayla, switch out Basculin for Trevenant. I don't want the AI bot taking the Trevenant. Plus, it'll give you more health to fight the Glalie with, as well as a Drain Punch. I forgot all about Trevenant, I just remember Phantump. I mean, it's hard to forget Danny Phantump. Danny Phantump is indeed quite memorable. Thank you very much, whoever subscribed right there. Thank you very much. We are 15 away from our next sub goal. Again, we literally cannot do any of this without you. You guys are the wonderful people that keep everything here going. Yeah, normally I very much like Bascu Fish. See, that's exactly why. That is exactly why I do not want the bots taking something that is very, very bad. So at the very least, Azumarill can kind of be useful. It's slightly useful. I love Danny Phantom, although I'm definitely not going to ask for a reboot. Look what they did to Teen Titans. Yeah. Like, ideally what they do is they just continue on Danny Phantom. I always remember the mom on the playthrough. Yeah, I know, I remember my playthrough Pokemon more. I bond with Pokemon through battling, so like, them in a story playthrough and them in competitive. And I have yet to use a Trevenant family in either of them. You just keep targeting me. Just target me. You barely do any damage to me. Hydro miss. Punch. Yeah, Drain Punch does decent damage to this thing. It's a weirdly lot of damage. Then again, Glalie has, garbage stats across the board. They're not garbage, it's just they're not great considering its moves. Like, if they gave the thing Ice Beam, they gave, Ice Beam, okay, maybe then it'd be useful, but they didn't give it Ice Beam. I'm actually going to use Max Geyser on this thing because I very much would prefer more damage on this thing. Because you're going to be annoying, Glalie. I mean, it's not great that we are all weak to Glalie's moves. So I'd ideally like to brute force this thing as much as possible. Yes, Froslass learned Ice Beam. Froslass does learn Ice Beam. Not in Dynamax Adventures, it gets Frost Breath, but it does learn Ice Beam. Okay, just keep targeting me. Just keep targeting me. Focus on the Lampfish. Focus exclusively on the Lampfish. Hello there, Alvinism. I'm going for Larvesta. It's very noticeable. Shiny Larvesta is very, very noticeable. I should know. Shiny Larvesta was one of our first ever shiny hunts we did in Scarlet Violet. It actually may have been the first. You think actually? I think it actually was the first shiny hunt we did. No special attack. Doesn't really matter all that much. Doesn't matter as much as the special attack. Against the Pelipper, just use Fake Tears on the Glalie. Do not Dynamax. I am under the water. That is not good. Cool, I want a Volcarona so bad. Okay. Yeah, only knock out 60 of them. After you knock out 60 of them, your odds of getting a shiny are maxed out. Then I recommend saving. After you knock out 60 of them. Then, if you want to make Sparkle or Encounter Power Sandwich, I recommend doing that. I need a lot of Vesta for two. Got a 2-for-1 special of Vesta and Fanfy. Nice. Well, you don't. If you do a sandwich, you only get boosted for that specific typing. Fanfy would not be boosted by the sandwich that would boost Larvesta. It's very, very noticeable, yeah. Like, it's very, very, very noticeable. Oh, yes. Glalie outspeeds me. So that means you go first, hit it with Fake Tears. Also, it's good. Also good because I Water Electric is a very good typing. The only issue with it is with Lantern is Lantern doesn't really have the stats. You know, it's Lantern doesn't really have the stats to necessarily make it work. No, do not switch Togetic. I want you to switch out the Togetic for the... Actually, rare NPC win. Because that's one of the few times rivalry comes in handy. Because Tornadus is always male. Not really. Not really higher in stats over everyone. It's more so, it's very low stat line makes it very weak. It can't really do out a lot of damage, and it can't really soak up hits well, and its move pool is kind of not great. I mean, in a world where there's a lot of bulky waters, it kind of doesn't distinguish itself in the same way something like Milotic does. Well, then again, it does still retain Scald, if I recall correctly. So, it does have a little bit of an edge these days. But if, like, you know, give it something like a 10-point bump to its physical defense, 10-point bump to its special defense, 10-point bump to its special attack, you know, maybe then it'd be a little bit better. No, the yellow sticks out very heavily. No, Larvesta sticks out very heavily. Yeah. Yeah, Lantern stats are really what hold it back. Furret's stats are not the greatest, but it gets one very good move. Tidy Up, which is a fantastic move. Yeah, that's why we love Fake Tears, absolute one-shot city. Demolition. Demolition. Yeah, Furret's kind of a case where stats and, again, not every Pokemon is decided purely by its stats. I mean, there's a lot of Pokemon that have really, really good stat lines and they just don't really do well. Yeah, switch out the Togetic for the Pelipper. Yes, now switch. Alright, so plan is just click Weatherball when it comes to Pelipper. Just click Weatherball. I am not going to switch out my item. Just click Weatherball. Glalie. First turn, click Fake Tears. Every turn after, click Ice Fang. And then when you can, Dynamax. Unless Tornadus decides to be nice and use Max Hailstorm. I mean, Furret is 5'11", so it's actually pretty big. It's taller than you, so it's actually pretty easy to hug. Furret is very friend-shaped. Eat this Thunderbolt. Learn set stats. Yeah, Furret's stats are not great, but it does get tidy up, which is a fantastic move. Like, Furret is very much a case where moves can compensate very heavily. Yeah. We don't even need to Dynamax. We don't even need to Dynamax. Because again, Fake Tears is one of the best moves there is. That's fine. It's 5'11", that's how long. That's pretty big. Remember, that is if a Furret stood up, It would be about 5 feet tall. You know, that's pretty big. That is a fairly big floof noodle. Yeah. No. Furt is gigantic. Furt is gigantic. That crit may not have mattered. That may not have mattered when it comes to the crit. Long noodle. Got the freeze. Tornado face was frozen solid. That crit did not matter. That crit absolutely did not matter. If you guys haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe for more. Leave a like. Someone sells 2-scale plushie for that is incredible. Watch a regional Furret get an evolution that's over 10 feet long. I'm pretty sure that's longer than Rayquaza. Oh, you know, the anime does not have height accurate sizing. The anime takes a lot of liberties with Pokemon heights. Like, remember, they have Groudon be, like, this Godzilla-sized monster. Groudon is, like, 10 foot 11. Like, 10 foot 6. It's tiny. Comparatively. Let's check our non-existent shiny. Tornadus. Take that counter up to 9. No shiny. Alright. Let's get going to the next lobby. Save the thing. Yes, we want to save the pathing for Tornado Face. Which Pokemon would go over today? Tornado Face. We go for Tornado Face. Yeah. Again, Groudon is tiny. Groudon is absolutely tiny. Let's go. Lobby open. Arbok is as long as Groudon's is tall. Yeah, again, that math checks out. That math checks out. You know, we love Furret, but like that's that again. 5'11" is tall. Same height as Pheromosa, by the way. Same height as Pheromosa. I'd get why Groudon sounds like a legendary that is peaked in high school etiquette of playing it. My thing is, Groudon gets better with each passing gen. Peonia tries to scam everybody. Peonia scams everybody. I never trust Peonia. She never brings me the pathings I want for legendaries. Ooh, go for the Electabuzz. Electabuzz is very good. Electabuzz is very, very good. Manectric, yes, please. So, here's the thing. Just spam, like, Rising Voltage on the thing because of the Helping Hand. Oh my gosh, this is perfect. Ooh, Auroras. Maybe I just Peonia's Sister Penny. Alright, what pathing do we go for? What pathing gives me more optimal checks? Okay. I mean, we have no real need for either pathing. Overall, I feel it's better to go for the Haunter. So we go for Haunter, then we just go until the Auroras. Yeah, we go Haunter, Ninkada, not Ninkada, Ninjask, and then we go for the... And then we go for the Auroras. Electabuzz, just use Helping Hand. Helping Hand the Manectric. Because Manectric got Lightning Rod, you will be unable to use any of your electric moves. You're trying to give me a path for Groudon. I already have that pathing. Yeah, she does that from time to time. She does that quite a lot. Again, I don't trust Peonia. It is a good habit to not trust Peonia. She doesn't really give good pathings a whole lot of the time. You know what? Smart light screen usage. Very smart light screen usage. This thing has all special moves. This thing has entirely special moves. Yeah, just use Psychic Fangs. Clap, clap, clappy, clap, clap. Munch. Munch, munch, munch. Chew, 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 swallow. Wait, oh, your ability is Vital Spirit, right. You can't be put to sleep. Razor Shell. Goodbye, Haunter. Spooky Ghost. You could indeed say we are ghost-busting right now. From the Galar games. We do not really ship characters here. We do not do that here. I don't know, I find something kind of weird. Aren't the characters like canonically like what, like 10 or 13 or something? No one switches out? I'm taking Darkrai's jab. Okay, then we go for the Ninkada. See, this... Actually, no, just use Helping Hand on me, because I've got Rock Slide, and Rock Slide would demo this thing. A Helping Hand boosted Rock Slide would demolish this freaking thing. The thing is, against Tornadus, just use Rising Voltage or Electroweb. Either of them is fine. Because... Worst case scenario, it purges the stats and abilities, which shuts down Lightning Rod. Which means you can use Electro Web or Rising Voltage against it. Best case scenario, it doesn't purge, and you just keep juicing up the Manectric. It's all good. I'm assuming both. Of course it uses Mud Slap on me. I'm gonna freaking miss Rock Slide now. I'm gonna freaking miss the Rock Slide. I'm gonna freaking miss Rock Slide because that accuracy drop. We'll get Speed Rose. We don't miss it! And then you get demolished. Freaking love, again, Helping Hand. Closet Tack. Absolute Closet Tack. When it comes to Helping Hand. Literally the best thing there is. The only issue is a lot of... It's kind of a not really... Because this is, again, this kind of goes into the main issue I've mentioned before about Dynamax Adventures. It was built with the understanding of a lot of the high-level competitive tactics. The issue for that being, most people don't know that stuff. Now we go for the Auroras. I am going to switch out for the Auroras. Because overall, I mean, Auroras is... No, I'm switching out so the bots can't do anything with it. Yeah, Bonehead, okay. Yeah, I switched out because I didn't want the AI bot to switch. Well, then again, the AI bot couldn't have done anything, like, worse. But, I mean, this is fine because I got a steel move on this thing. I have no idea what that is, Cohen. No idea what you mean by that. But yeah, no, like, Auroras is probably the best answer to Tornado Face. And if you guys haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe for more. Leave a like on the stream. You guys are the ones that keep everything going. Communicating. No, don't use Overheat. Just use Psychic Fangs or Rising Voltage. Actually, just use Rising Voltage. Don't use Overheat. Remember, it's not weak to Overheat. Yeah, you know what? NPC is smart using sub. I do not eat crayons. Yeah, go for Rising Voltage from here on out on Manectric. Just go for Rising Voltage now. We do not have any fighting type moves. The best we've got is a steel move on the Bonehead. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna Dynamax the Manectric. You're gonna Dynamax the Manectric. Welcome in, Watcher. Hope you're doing well. The Bonehead. Wah. He's very Bonehead. Helping Hand. Clap, clap, clappy, clap, clap. I'm Tornado Brain. Hello there, Dark DK. How you doing? Smart using that. Smart using that. Keep debuffing. Yeah, this thing's bulky. Thankfully, you can't get paralyzed. The electro types cannot be paralyzed. But how you doing? Would it be broken if you could use all of them? Yes! That would be broken. That would be extremely broken. That's the reason why you can't use Z-moves on a Mega Rayquaza. That would be absolutely ludicrous levels of broken. It wasn't the answer stream. No, it's all good. It's all good, Dark. Ashen Masters 8 be like. I'm sorry, what? I don't understand, Bruce. Please explain. I have confusion. What's Masters 8? What is Masters 8? I have no idea who that is. Good thing holidays in 3 weeks. Nice. Didn't watch it, so I'm going off what I saw in the AMVs. Ah. Yeah, I have no idea what Masters 8 is. I'm switching out. Yeah, no, it's... Having all of the gimmicks together in a single game would be absolutely broken beyond compare. It's just a lot of people really, really, really like Mega Evolutions. They want them back. Yeah, Black Hole clips on random tank attack. Yeah, no, it would be horribly broken. Years ago, I made a video script actually covering that exact thing. Hello there, Lisa. Say, yeah, years ago, I made a script kind of covering that exact thing, which is basically going over all the super mechanics. It was freaking, what, 40 pages long? Which would have translated to something in the ballpark of around 3-4 hours long for a video. So I just never ended up making it. We give love to Maractus. Hey Alex, welcome in. Stack attack, I'm more like that. Hello there, Captain Alex. How you doing? I don't think Corviknight needs a Mega. Corviknight is a fantastic Pokemon as is. Do you have the DLC and do you have Nintendo Switch Online for Sword and Shield, Lisa? Hello there. All four gimmicks. Everything's broken. No, Alex. That's copium right there, no. You don't realize how absolutely absurd terrastalizing legendaries is when it comes to something like a Z-move. You have no clue how crazy that would be. Alright, so go to Max Layer in the Crown Tundra and connect to the internet. And then it's like anything is fine. But how are you guys doing? Welcome in. Come on, the mods, go grab Alex, Captain Alex's link, please. And if you guys haven't done so already, please don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more. Terrestrializing my Mega Shiner Rayquaza doing his move. Yeah, it would be insane. Like, it. That would be incredibly overpowered and toxic. That it's. That would be very not good. Alright, so when the next thing goes up, then we'll go to that. Imagine using Acid Downpour, any Z move and getting stab on. Yeah. Well, the thing is, if Primal Groudon terrastalized, it actually would be easier to take out. Because it could only terrastalize into one type. The thing that made Groudon horrifying was the fact that it had, you know, to the typing combination. Also, it couldn't even hold a Z-move crystal. Okay, with Dynamax, yeah, no, that'd be nightmares. That'll be nightmares. Corviknight does not need a Mega and stop spamming Dark. It was the same as having BSD of Demon Riders. Hi, Neko, how you doing? Come on, the mods, go grab Neko's link, please, as well. How you doing? I mean, it's not like Game Freak gives a method. Oh no, they do! They actually do! They nerfed Parental Bond. They nerfed the Ruined Legendaries before they came out. They nerfed Intimidate. They nerfed Zacian. They nerfed Zamazenta. They actually do care about balancing. You gotta remember, Iron Bundle is good, but it's not the supreme destroyer of worlds. People, especially those in the aggressive competitive community, like to overinflate things' strength. Remember, to use your own thing against you. They nerfed Landorus Therian. They have heavily nerfed Landorus Therian. So, to join the Dynamax adventure, you talk to this lady. You select anything is fine. Then, when you're on the screen right after selecting anything is fine, press the plus button, type in the link code 19283746, and then select invite others, then you'll be able to join. But welcome in, J-Love, welcome in. And well, how do they nerf? They lowered its stats and they nerfed Dauntless Shield and Intrepid Sword. They nerfed the stats and they nerfed the ability. They also nerfed Greninja and they nerfed Protean. Protean and Libero. Again, they do care about balancing. I know you're probably not going to believe this. You're right, Oz. I don't believe you. I don't believe you. Given, like, what, like 3 weeks ago, you still had the intense hate of that? No, Lazarus Specs is not banned officially. Got it, Lazup. They nerfed me in the last update. I mean, ground types are good in general. Like, I would say overall, ground has the best effectiveness profile. Maybe second only to ice in terms of offensive effectiveness profile. And again, if you guys haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe for more. Leave a like on the stream. And thank you all. Also, why is Zamazenta a fighting type and Zacian's a fairy type? While Zacian is one with the Schwarred. Yeah, I got no idea. Yeah, that doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. I think it's because they wanted to make a physical fairy type attacker. That is my entire thinking line. They wanted to make a physical, aggressive fairy type. Did you click invite others and did you type in the link code correctly? Remember, you need to select anything is fine to join.
Need a sand type.
I mean, that's ground. The thing is, adding in more types to Pokemon would be a problem. Like, we saw this when they added fairy typing. You can't really introduce a new typing into Pokemon and have things not just completely break. Because of how complex Pokemon's interactions are. Probably also Azumarill and Mawile are the other ones. Well, Mawile, well, Mega Mawile no longer exists. And Azumarill isn't always an attacker. Remember, it has Sap Sipper and it has Thick Fat. You know, Azumarill isn't always run as an attacker. None of these are good. Linoone is least bad. Megas no longer exist. Megas were taken out of the game in Gen 8.
I think Fairy should be weak to Bug to balance.
Yeah, that would balance out. Again, that would balance a lot of things out. Even just making it a neutrality to Bug would have fixed a lot of things. Go for Nidoking. Yeah. The issue of... do you put it in... Yes. You put the link code in before you click invite others. That's the only way you can search for other people.
Let's go check what our options are. What bug type is that?
Oh, it's Orbeetle. Ew. Okay. We are going... We're going for the Glalie. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We switch out Nidoking for Glalie. I'm sure you can out your Zygarde, Lisa. You can out your Zygarde. We're in. You can out your Zygarde raids. Hello there, Austin. Well, yes, but they were removed from Sword and Shield, BDSP, and Scarlet Violet, and very likely they're not going to be in the next mainline games following Black, following ZA.
Then ZA will bring back all of the Megas, I bet. Hopefully, Mega Black.
I don't think we're going to be getting new Megas. I think we're going to be getting the old Megas back. But this is one thing that I think is actually going to be happening with Megas in ZA. we're not going to be able to use them. Megas are going to be this game's version of alphas. So you fight, say, like a Mega Charizard. But then it just reverts to being a regular Charizard afterwards. You know, like, they're basically boss fights, but you are not able to use them yourself, I'm thinking, is what they're going to be doing.
Is busted.
Yes, but you cannot use alphas with their special bonuses. Remember, when you fight alphas, they have increased damage and decreased damage taken. Well, they have increased damage and increased damage resistance. When you catch them, they're literally just a regular Pokemon that's just slightly bigger than normal. But when you fight them, they have bonus stats. No, not Nobles. Just the Alphas. The regular Alphas have that as well, not just the Nobles.
I think Metal will be more like the Nobles.
I think no Pokemon deserves a Mega. I mean, again, that's kind of not that dissimilar from the Alphas. What I mean is, you're gonna be able to fight Megas roaming around the region, not just the story battles like with the Nobles were. I know what you mean. But I don't think they're just gonna be story battles. I think they're gonna be regular roaming, wandering things. Just refresh the stream if the stream is glitching.
Pretty good, we're gonna deserve something.
No Pokemon deserves anything. Dark, last warning. Switch out the Nidoking. Good. Hello, Xander. No Pokemon deserves a Mega Flame. No Pokemon deserves hero worship or special treatment. Lisa, we do Zygarde raids with our friend Thunder every so often. I said stop. This is the... With the whole Corviknight deserves a Mega, we have been over this before. I do not like to be this hard and aggressive on things. However, the rules need to be followed. When I say stop spamming, stop.
Dragon needs something because he's only like designed like shiny. Yeah.
I mean, it's got sheer force. It's got a very good move in sheer force. Yes, you are. You are repeating the same thing over and over again after we have said not to.
Oh yeah, it's got a Gigantamax.
What is Xander? I mean, again, Gigantamax no longer exists.
Let me go for Snow, but this thing has predominantly special attacks.
Just use fake tears, Glalie.
Yeah, Pokemon.
The funny thing is that Corviknight's G-Max was actually worse than the regular Dynamax with Corviknight. That's just how good Max Airstream was. You're right, Dredagon did do nothing wrong.
You know, if I stack with Dragon types, the Dredagon is kind of left out to Ross.
Honestly, Haxorus wasn't even really that great back in Generation 5. Like, in a story playthrough, Dredagon is okay. But when it comes to, like, competitive, Dredagon is not that great. The issue is, it's just way too frail.
I feel like mons that people say need a Megas are...
Not really. Just giving a Pokemon, like, an extra, 10 stats increase would really fix a lot of them. Like, if you just gave, say, Flygon an extra, 10 base speed points, that would actually fix a lot of its problems. It would actually outspeed something like, say, Garchomp. Yes, Mudkip has always been here.
And yes, I do believe you're right, Cohen. A lot of Megas, a lot of Pokemon, judged by their designs, such Pokemon can have sick moves, that's what you should have.
Yeah! Exactly, true. Like, again, it goes back to the whole thing before. There is no Pokemon that deserves to be good. All Pokemon do not deserve to, like, some, there are certain Pokemon that do not deserve to be better than others. The reason why is that leads into a lot of the conflict we've been seeing within the community lately. Switch out the Cofagrigus for the Starmie. What is the question? Like, it is the specific hero worship of certain Pokemon that has created a lot of the problems in the community as is. Let's go fight the Alolan Marowak. Glalie, just use fake tears.
All Pokemon are not UAV food.
Yes, the thing is, Watcher, a large part of that comes from that Game Freak specifically selectively promotes certain Pokemon over others. Yes, there are not every Pokemon is loved equally. But when Game Freak is specifically pushing people to like certain Pokemon over certain others, that's when that becomes a problem. Hello there, plays. Welcome in. You're not late. Nobody is late. They arrive precisely when they mean to.
I like new forms, just in my opinion, but I think we'll have a Pokemon or like a primate.
The thing is, Annihilate, that's not a help to Primate. Because Annihilate existing doesn't help Primate. Annihilate is its own distinct Pokemon. It just branches off from Primate. But Primate on his own, Annihilate does not help Primate intrinsically. I have no idea how to pronounce that name. That's kind of why I... That's kind of why I just said plays. I don't know how to pronounce that first part of the name.
Being loved equally. There's nothing called being loved equally. It's just the way the world works.
Yes. The problem is when the company creating it selectively promotes certain Pokemon over others. You know, that's kind of the issue, is when Game Freak is pushing, you know, people to like certain Pokemon and almost making people be wrong for not liking others. You know, the way I've always been is give stuff to the audience and let them decide. It is not up to the makers of a franchise to determine what the audience will like and will dislike when the entire founding principle of the Pokemon games was make your own journey. Where every Pokemon is an individual meant to be loved by each person in their own way. Specifically marketing specific Pokemon kind of flies directly in the face of that. You know, I'll take this. I'll take it.
And he started his way.
Mup, okay, thank you, Mup. Oh, what was well said, Watcher?
I like Pokemon Game Freak pushes, bashing them for liking them is no better than bashing.
When, the thing is, Alex, when Game Freak pushes those Pokemon at the expense of others, then I think that is justifiable. When Game Freak is selectively pushing certain Pokemon over others, basically to the point of you are wrong for not liking these Pokemon, I would say the pushback is deserved. I would say that is deserved. Because it is specifically through Game Freak's own actions, they allowed the idea of it is okay to preferentially like and preferentially dislike certain Pokemon. It is a simple basic principle of they either treat them all equally or they don't. Alex, when they literally have the entire plot of several games focusing on older Pokemon, I would say that's almost as clear-cut as anything. When you're specifically making a number of inbuilt game environments only to emulate and selectively bring back others at the expense of itself, I would say yes, it does. Remember, Gen 6's Dex is the smallest Dex of any region. And the reason for that was so they could make Megas. 71 new Pokemon. Or 72 new Pokemon. For 30 Megas. Yeah. And then, you know, things like the anime fixating on certain Pokemon. No, they like, routinely making 3 to 4 arcs for a specific Pokemon every single region of the anime. They do. That is something Game Freak does do. I do like Weavile. I like Weavile. Again, there's very few Pokemon I actively dislike. The only two Pokemon I actively dislike are the ones that basically Game Freak rams down your throat. Well, rams down your throat relative to their introduction time. Because there are certain Pokemon that, like, yes, they've been pushed as time's gone on, but that's actually only the relatively smaller part of their lifespan. And the Pokemon did at least earn its own merits, initially. Why did they ban the Porygon line? It's really because of negative association, Cohen. It's entirely because of a negative association that episode had. Because that was Porygon's debut episode, and that episode caused problems. As well as, they really can't blame Pikachu for causing the problems in the Porygon episode, because it was literally the mascot. So they just scapegoated Porygon. Alright, the Pokemon for the company did to them, rather the fans of Cubs. See, Flick, I agree with that. The issue is when Game Freak continues to feed it. The issue is that Game Freak could entirely stop it. By, well, decapitating the worship of those specific Pokemon. By toning down the official, you know, recognition of those things. But they don't. Like, there's only one Pokemon that they basically aggressively pushed from its beginning, and then they rolled back all the fan service they gave, and that was actually Cinderace. No shiny. But the others, they continue to keep pumping them up, even after they have become a problem.
More than Charizard, but the Greninja fans.
Yeah.
Same thing.
Yeah, I don't disagree, but again, it's... They still continuously buff all those Pokemon. Again, I don't think it is correct to go out, you know, basically harass people over the favorite Pokemon. I think that it is... Oh, you dislike the individual Pokemon, and to, you know, of course, highlight, you know, kind of the hypocrisy of those people who like those fans, but, again, it's not going to go harass the individual people for that, because, again, it's not that. One star in the solar system. But the Pokemon itself is the problem, and it is a problem that Game Freak does not actually rectify. So I do say that it is on Game Freak's point. It is on Game Freak for that.
Like, I would like to say Charizard would beat Ash Greninja 1v1, but Ash Greninja pushes the narrative, trying to narrow the best Pokemon.
Yeah. I would say they are very underrated. You know, the Greninja was actually kind of a good point, because... The difference between Greninja and Cinderace is that they pushed Cinderace aggressively from the beginning. But they've rolled back a lot of the stuff they did for Cinderace. They rolled back, you know, they nerfed Libero. It doesn't have anything special in Gen 9. It's, you know, basically just a regular Pokemon for all intents and purposes these days. Whereas they are still routinely buffing Greninja. You know, they're still basically doing everything they can to keep Greninja on top.
What's funny is Cinderace was so pushed just for Rillaboom to beat it. But...
Yeah. Yeah, again, like, that is kind of the issue. Like, Cinderace is like the story of Game Freak recognizing something's a problem and scaling back what they're doing, which they need to do more. The problem is, there is two Pokemon that their entire identity is built on that level of basically hero worship. And this is going to be something that I'm going to basically cover in another video, but those two Pokemon, everything they have is built on that. It's a case of, if you took away those things, those Pokemon would drop off a cliff. Hello there, Hand 3. It's going quite well. Landorus is mid-notice. Yes, I agree, Watcher. Lando is quite mid these days. It still needs to be respected. It's nowhere near what it once was, but it does still need to be respected. Nope, it's not Pikachu and Eevee. Even with all the stuff they get, those things are still bad. It is not Pikachu and Eevee. One of them is Greninja. Greninja is one of them.
They need to do with Pikachu and Charizard.
Again, the thing is, Charizard's actually lost basically everything they gave it. Like, I am all for the rallying against a lot of the favorite stuff, but I do believe it's not Charizard. The thing is, Charizard's been doing the same thing it's always been doing since Gen 5, and that is Solar Power Sun Sweeper. Charizard is a Pokemon that has kind of proven it never needed the Mega or the G-Max to be good. It's just people know the Mega, but it's always been doing that Sun Power thing, because, like, a Charizard using Solar Power, like, fire moves are actually stronger. Yes, you are correct. It is that one.
I'm going to go Wigglytuff. Ooh, Celio.
Again, like, Charizard is the popular one to hate, but it's like, it's done the same thing for basically a decade and a half at this point. Solar Power Sun moves. That is all it does. The best way to sort of conceptualize this is, even if you took G-Max Charizard out of the equation from Gen 8, it wouldn't really change what Charizard would have done back in Gen 8. It still would have gone Dynamax and use fire moves. Because it's a Sun Sweeper. Its whole thing is big sun move go burr. Alright, we are going to go... We're going to go Lycanroc.
That ring is bogus. I found it in the Cracker Jack box. There's what's inside you, Lodestar. Think about Kalos Champion has a Charizard.
Kalos' Champion doesn't have a Charizard. Kalos' Champion has a Diancie.
Wasn't every Pokemon anime.
Oh, in the anime. I mean, the anime is different than the games themselves. Yeah, the anime is very, very different. Because, I mean, the anime is definitely a large part of that problem, I will say. That is a large part of the problem.
The champion has a Charizard.
Didn't Leon lose in the anime, though?
Tornadus is good in rain because they exist to make feel like harmony.
Tornadus is very good.
I'm
We Dynamax the Cramoran against this thing. And then we switch out Cramoran for it.
So you thought it was Zulamon, dude. I could do a God kill streak.
But yeah, no, it's like, again, Charizard fundamentally has done the same thing it has for generations. Like, it's just Sunsweeper.
Diance was the undisputed champion of the XY, yet they reduced her to the spectator in the anime. Two different worlds, indeed.
What do you mean, Diance? You mean Gardevoir? I don't know. But yeah, no, it's just kind of interesting. Again, Charizard's done the same thing. Just I used to hate Charizard when I was younger. Didn't it get belly drum back in Gen 2, though? But yeah. Well, again, that was even more. But even it still did run on Sun teams, even before Solar Power was a thing. Because, again, Sun boosted Fire moves and Solar Beam is a hell of a thing. It would still run on Sun teams. That's a large part of why it was they gave it Solar Power, was it naturally did Sun things.
It has Belly Drum. This event has a good move.
The event, really? I thought it was an egg move. I thought it was an egg move that Charizard got Belly Drum with. Hello there, Nick. Welcome in. We do not cook the Cramorant.
Belly Drum. Let's go check.
So I thought it was. I always thought it was an egg move.
Reading.
No, it was an egg move. Charmander got it as an egg move.
Yeah, look at him, Cleffa.
Yeah, like the list of things that got Belly Drum as an egg move: Charmander, Slowpoke, Cubone, Lickitung, Cleffa, Meryl, Teddy Ursa. Well, no, Teddy Ursa got it in Gen 4. You know, there was not... Yeah. It was the Wooper that had the event Belly Drum. Yeah, it was Wooper that got it in Gen 2 as an event move. You might be thinking of the Rapid Spin Golem. You know, I am all for blasting the popular Pokemon, but do it fairly. You know, when it is deserved. Again, you could literally write like a 10-page dissertation on like the history of like Charizard in the community. It's kind of fascinating.
Wooper is too powerful.
Hello there, Echo. How you doing?
Freak. I think Lycanroc Sandrush. Freaking heck, this thing's a monster. Applethon is weirdly terrifying to me. Imagine an apple pie and have the Dragon Balls.
Well, I mean, it's not an apple. It just resembles an apple.
I like Charizard too.
Yeah. Again, I respect Charizard. I respect base Charizard, because base Charizard is quite good. It never needed all the extra stuff. I'm well.
Applelin's not an apple. It's a worm inside of an apple. Like an apple. Yeah. It is a worm inside of an apple. Every like one of their favorites.
They do. But again, that's the problem. Again, it doesn't need all the extra kidding bullshit. Again, it never should have gotten that much. Okay, we switch out the Cramorant for this. I honestly do not expect us to be able to beat... I do not expect us to be able to beat Tornado Face.
Yeah, I do not expect Tornadus to be able to be Rimble. Dope is a mediocre.
That's not good.
That is not good. But again, it's like, again, the favoritism in Pokemon is a bit of a simple thing, but let's move to a different topic. Nicola, switch out the Cramorant for the Lycanroc.
Yeah, I don't really like our option. I don't really like our thing here. How many stars on this?
HTD. We already said one, and do not spam. Fairy does need a nerf. They call a perfect starter gen to look at Game Freak. Why? I'm sure Incineroar is being pushed. The funny thing is, it wasn't even Incineroar that was pushed. Incineroar wasn't even the pushed one.
Yeah, it's a Pincurchin.
Alright, from here on out, we just kind of got to hope for the best. Yeah, like, really, Decidueye was kind of the more pushed one of them. It's just Incineroar was the good one competitively. But even, like, they didn't push Decidueye all that much. Like, again, they didn't push it. Alola and, of all things, Hoenn are the two most respectful gens when it comes to individual starters. Yes. Incineroar likely was picked because one Decidueye probably would have been a lot harder to incorporate into the game. Because, like, it's a burn, its whole thing is archery, kind of a bit difficult to incorporate that into the game. And, you know, how do you make Primarina work? You know, they learned from Ivysaur, it's not exactly easy to do something like that, you know, non-humanoid things. Yeah. Again, it's always worth remembering. They put Greninja in Smash 3 before X and Y was even out. Greninja is the only Pokemon to date that was designed jointly. HAL Labs and Pokemon Company designed Greninja so that they could have it in Smash that way.
Drew Pokemon.
Well, Pokken isn't made by Game Freak. That's made by a different company, and they have actually a lot of non-human Pokemon that were able to work in that game. That's a bit of a different thing.
Edit a Pokemon.
Yeah, again, it's a bit different. Likely they went with Incineroar because it was the most easily includable one, because again, it's just a humanoid shape. As well as they wanted to make it like a heavy character, because also Incineroar's move kit does, like, the moves Incineroar has access to do make more sense for a fighting game. It has a counter, it has, you know, different things that actually work for it. I love Decidueye, but I do struggle to see how you would be able to incorporate, like, Decidueye into Smash.
Going starters are favorites every couple of moments.
Yeah. Like, that's why, like, I point to the Hoenn starters, like, the most respectful way of incorporating, you know, the historic Pokemon in there. Because if you look at the way they were handled just in the anime, they never really spotlighted any of the three Hoenn starters, really. Like, Brock got Martop, I mean, he never evolved into Swampert. But he had the Mudkip and eventually evolved it into Marsh Stomp. You had May had Blaziken, and Ash had Sceptile. So it's like, they focused on each of the different starters, and I like that. Yeah.
Hey, we have a plushie. Still have not gotten him without a battle.
Hope we got that Weavile. But anyway, again, like, that shows how similar the favoritism of the Hoenn starters is, that, you know, no one was pushed. Yeah, but the thing is, Blaziken got its Mega first.
Remember, Blaziken's Mega was literally used as a marketing gimmick for X and Y. The whole thing was, like, if you got X and Y early, you could get Mega Blaziken. And if I recall, that was actually, like, the only way to get Mega Blaziken for a long time. Like, I don't know if it was even possible to get Mega Blaziken otherwise. Let me go check. Like, was it possible to even get the Blaziken Megastone in X and Y outside of that event, or could you not? Nope. Yeah, no, you could only get it through the event. If you didn't get, like, that pre-order, or, like, that early access X and Y with it, you just couldn't get Mega Blaziken. Yeah. Like, they did good with the Hoenn stars, like, you know, representing all of them. Until, you know, X, until X and Y. Yeah, again, that's kind of a separate thing. But again, let's switch the topic to something different. Let's switch the topic from the negativity. And that is a hard and fast order. If that does not change, then there will be timeouts given.
I am not going to switch out. Come on, NPC, switch out.
Good, MC switched out.
Does not, is just a victim.
Again, we are switching to a different topic. Now. Let's go. Is it Palpitoad or Druddigan? I think we go Druddigan. It's just better. We go for the Druddigan. Or Palpitoad, either of them is fine. I just think we have a bit of a harder time with the Palpitoad. Guys? Timeouts will be handed out.
Do we even want to have a Dynamax against that thing?
Actually, yes. First turn Howl. That's what we do. Yes, that is shiny Tornadus on the bottom. Tornadus' shiny doesn't really change a whole lot. Yeah, Tornadus' shiny does not change that much. But we are doing a living shiny deck, so we do need to get all of the shinies. We must acquire all of them. I honestly have no idea what brought me to the Pokemon community. I honestly have no clue.
Those regular results, Jim Tom.
Yeah, no, it is the shiny. Yeah, again, a lot of shinies didn't change a whole lot. That just because of the color palette algorithm. That was just the color palette algorithm. Do, do, do. Now I'm just going to be using...
Yeah. There's probably a mixture of nostalgia and overall something.
Yes, exactly, Wilkins. Exactly. Exactly.
I'm not going to be either. Maybe you just started to watch this, and maybe that's not how to do a better play, though.
And can play competitive. Nice. Fun. Yeah, I'm looking forward to Regulation G. Actually, let's go check Pikalytics. I want to see where things are looking... I want to see where Pikalytics things are looking like right now for Reg G. Because they should have the Smogon Regulation G up. Really, they don't have Smogon's Reg G up right now. Interesting. Wow, Fluttermane's only at 46% usage. How the mighty have fallen.
How the mighty have fallen. I messed up with Smogon. Sweet little rain team for the giggles. Nice. Besides that, Meta, what's your favorite shiny of every type?
Normal, I've got no clue. I really don't know too many normal shinies. Water would probably be Kyogre. I just really love purple. Or Sveok, again, purple. Again, it's basic, but I do like shiny Charizard. Grass? Maybe Ferrothorn. I do love shiny Ferrothorn or Kartana. Both of them are fantastic. Dragon. I actually don't know what my favorite shiny dragon would be. Maybe Kingdra. Because, again, purple. But I don't actually know that. And, you know, Giratina. Same with shiny ghost, Giratina, by a mile. Fairy would be Togekiss. Flying would also be Togekiss. Steel. Still probably Magneton. Magnezone. I do love shiny Magnezone. Rock would be Gigalith. I do love my shiny Gigalith. I actually don't know. Like, I honestly don't really know, because I've never really thought about that. I'm going to go for Wiseglass. I can't go for Life Orb. Okay, so we Dynamax the Lycanroc. Lycanroc, turn one. Use Howl. Use Howl, and then Dynamax, and use Dynamax Stone Edge.
There's so many types. Let me name it.
Yeah. I mean, the other thing is, if I had, like, a list of all the Pokemon in front of me, I would be able, like, to easily pick it out. But it's, like, going off memory, I can't really do that. Like, I really don't know what, like, the vast majority of shinies look like. Now, unless I am specifically hunting for a shiny, I actually don't remember what it looks like. Alright, this is gonna be risky. If it uses Icy Wind, we have a chance. If it doesn't use Icy Wind, then we are, you know, it's a little bit not good here for our heroes. Oh, okay, I get competitive boost. That's actually what I was hoping for, because now I get +2 from competitive. It's basically a free nasty plot. It's probably gonna do, like, no damage. It's probably gonna do frick off no damage. Thankfully, again, we do have one more life. Yeah, got some chip damage. That's fine. That's perfectly good. I mean, that's a decent amount of damage right there. If you guys haven't done so already, don't forget to leave a like on the stream. Subscribe for more. Yeah, now we Dynamax the doggo. They are 150 more. So you have, yeah, there's over 1,000 Pokemon now. It's, I believe, 1,025 Pokemon is what the list is up to now. I remember when I was trying to beat Legends Abacus, I realized I was missing something. I thought everything was all time, and I realized it was Chirim. Yeah, Chirim and Cherubi are the annoying ones to get to level 10, because if I remember, you can only find them in trees. For me, I actually finished Chirim before Cherubi. Well, I think we're screwed. Well, no, you have Sandrush. So, maybe not. Maybe not. Maybe we outspeed the thing next turn and take it down. Or not, we just win. Or not, I really did not think it would do that much damage. I mean, I know that it's +1. But I did not think it would do that much damage. That crit was excessive. Like, if it was a crit, understandable, that would have made sense. But I did not expect it to delete, like, 70% of its HP. Holy crap, that damage. Again, don't forget to subscribe if you guys haven't done so already, guys.
So I did not suffer.
Yeah, that's the smart decision, is transferring in from home. Because if you just trade it back and forth with someone, and just transfer it in out from home, it actually does that same thing. Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of funny. They made Legends Arceus to be like, okay, you have to play the game a whole lot, but people ended up just finding ways to circumvent it. I kind of find that the most amusing thing. Which is one of the reasons I do not expect them to ever bring back dex tasks in future games. No shinies. Because they saw people were not... Okay, maybe not. Maybe they will bring them back, but like heavily decrease the requirements for it. Maybe they could cut everything in half. Because this is kind of the interesting thing about having a game like Legends Arceus where you have a lot of grinding stuff to do. People will always find ways to circumvent it. So they don't need to go. They don't need to go and do it. We saw this with the master trainers in Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee, where the idea was, you know, you get to use every Pokemon and you learn the strengths in and out of each and every Pokemon. But in the end, no one went and did that because the requirements for stats were so absolutely absurd that people basically just toxic stalled everything. Okay, have a good lurk. You know, just, it's kind of funny, and it's like they didn't learn that lesson on that. Maybe they will for future stuff. And again, if you want to join, feel free to pop in. Missing something, even though everything was level 10. Yeah, you didn't have a Charim registered. Yeah. Legends is, I still wonder what they're going to do for Legends EA. I have my private worries about that game. I do have my private worries that it is basically going to be like a city-building simulator. It's not even going to be like an actual Pokemon game. But we never know. We never know. We just need to wait and see. We just need to wait and see. We just need to wait, fluff around, and find out. Yeah, we got a couple videos on that planned. We got a couple videos on that. What to beat Legends Advocate. Yeah. Yeah, I think we can kind of base future stuff for ZA based on what we saw from Legends, Legends Arceus, and then kind of plan from there. But I wonder what they're going to do for Gen 10. But that's the big question, is what is the Gen 10 plans? Because I think it was a very, very deliberate thing where they have a year off to distract everyone with Legends ZA. So people don't basically ruin stuff for Gen 10. Again, we don't know yet, but I think that was a very smart plan on their part. Yeah, we have no clue. We have no clue, but we'll figure out eventually. Alright, I don't think anyone else is going to be popping in. Changing abilities in Gen 10. I mean, abilities already can be changed. That's what the ability patch and ability capsule's for. Scum tank, none of those are good. None of these are good, but like the least bad is probably the Sea King. Or the Mantine because of the Wide Guard. None of those were good. Okay, at least they picked up the Persian. That's at least useful. We need to find something good. Okay, Stunfisk. That's actually usable. The Stunfisk is good. Okay. Stunfisk or that. No, that's the hard pick. Okay. Oh, no, it's a Rotom over there. Okay. So... Alright, we go Stunfisk, Charmeleon, Rotom. I am going to hold on to... Why is the fish so violent? The reason why is we had a Dynamax Adventure run where the NPC Stunfisk literally KO'd everything. So it literally knocked out everything. It knocked out us a few times. No, it did knock out a few times. It was with the NPC, and the NPC landed all four knockouts. It was hilarious. It was absolutely freaking hilarious. I loved it. Yeah, unfortunately, from that one, the floating frisbee. I mean, it's a angelfish, I believe is what it is. I don't actually remember what it's called. But if you guys haven't done so already, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe for more, and let us know how you're doing today, everyone. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe for more. Flash out. We can't really do much to this thing, though. Just gotta wait. Stunfisk is a Mudskipper Flash. Ah! Yeah, I don't. I'm not the best up to date when it comes to fishology. I study rocks. Is what I study. Fish is not nearly anywhere close to my specialty. But yeah, no. We go. We fluff around and find out. We do a little fluff around and find out. I just hope we can knock this thing out quick. Yes, you have literally picked up exactly on it, Dolphin. That is exactly it. Yeah, it probably was. But we get a membership exclusive content. We have members only streams. The thing is, we've been kind of working on some other products in the meantime. I'm gonna take after Thunder's last stream. Hey, Floorhead, how are you doing? How's Floorhead? So as I was saying, why Pikachu is the worst Pokemon in the series? I think I don't even want to know what happened in Thunder's last stream. I don't even think I want to. I decided I'm going back to Unova again. Really? Heading back to Unova? It's almost like Unova's the best region. I wonder why.
It does indeed make you think for a second. Going back to Unova. Most curious indeed.
Yeah, we're probably gonna do a later stream tonight. I feel like I'm wearing the poison powder. That's not good, Wilkins. That's not good. You know it's fun flashbacks losing to Alyssa 90 times in one row. Yeah, she was brutal. Again, some of the hardest games.
Sounds more like a case of stun thwart, Wilkins.
Yeah, possibly. Switch out the Sea King for this. Yeah, because then you get Thunder.
Thunderbolt, my team was severely underleveled.
I mean, even if you're adequately leveled to face her, she more or less holds the advantage over your team. Her team is kind of absurd in that way. Because she has a Pokemon that is super effective to every single one of the starters and the fossils. So it's like, she's an electric type gym leader that largely does not have the same problems as most electric type gym leaders. Emolga. Because Emolga is flying electric, and by that point in the game, you're going to have a Pignite, and you're going to have, Servine is going to be Servine as grass in the beginning. They're both Pignite and Servine are weak to flying, and Duat is weak to electric. And he's got two of them. So it's like, even if you have, you know, like a thing that, hello there, Yoga Rosa, welcome in.
I heard a lot of people hate.
I have no idea what the Echo Dolphin games are.
I like the occasional hard, like my username comes from one of the Pokemon next to my people picks, you know.
Yeah, fair enough. Fair enough. You guys haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe for more. Thank you very much, Yogurt. Thank you very much for that. Of course we got paralyzed. Of course.
Yeah, because there's a musical collapse. Oh, yeah, Unova's music is second to none. Like, that's, like, I'm hoping when they eventually do the Gen 5 remakes, I can't wait to hear that music. Like, I love what they did for the music in Oras. They did a great job with that. So, like, what they would do with the music for Unova, I can't even imagine, like, how great that could be. Thank you very much. Good, they used the fire move on the thing that is not bothered by, of course, Persian's paralyzed. Of course. Spree. I think at this point it should, yes, Earth Power, I think, Earth Power will take it down. Good. Oh, we got Shell Bell, fun. Alright, I think Rotom needs to be the Dynamax against Tornado Face. What's Auras theme? Yuwali's Auras theme is great. Like, that's what makes me hopeful when we get the eventual Unova remakes. I'm not expecting Unova remakes to happen for another, like, 3 years at this point. Because, you know, ideally, I'd like to see it in 2026. Like, nothing, absolutely nothing, would make me just grin with just, like, the dumbest grin on my face more than if for the 30th anniversary of Pokemon, they do nothing for Gen 1. And instead what they do is they make it a Gen 5 thing. Nothing would make me happier. But I doubt that is gonna be what happens. Yeah, it would just be like, it would be like the grin I had during Godzilla Kong the New Empire, where it's this just dumb happy grin of, I didn't think this would happen. But it is, and I love it. But yeah, I expect they're probably gonna do, like, maybe what they do for the 30th anniversary, they don't even release a Gen 10. They just do, we are going to, I don't know, release the Gen 1 games on the Switch or something? I don't know. I have no clue. Of course we both got paralyzed. Yeah, there's no way they're gonna do that for the 30th anniversary. I'd love it, but there's no way they're doing it. There's no way they're gonna do that. Of course we couldn't hit that. We literally did no damage to it the entire first turn. Let's Go Pikachu sequel. I don't think we're ever getting a sequel to Let's Go Pikachu. This is my, like, crazy theory. That originally, Let's Go was going to be their spin-off experimental game franchise, like sub-franchise within Pokemon. But when that game was absolutely blasted as hard as it was, they retooled everything and rebranded it to Legends. Because the thing is, Legends Arceus as a game is very similar to a lot of the ideas and a lot of the mechanic and systems that are actually within Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee. They are very, very similar in a lot more ways than people, I think, want to admit. Because it brings up some very uncomfortable ideas. And that, like, I think what they were originally going to do is basically do, you know, the Let's Go sub-series, and then that was basically going to be, like, you know, their sub-series that Legends is today. But after that game just freaking was dead on arrival, they realized, okay, we can't do this. We have to go in, you know, another direction for everything. You freaking, I hate this thing. I freaking hate this thing. Yeah, Assurance, if I hit that, Assurance would have taken it out. How hard is it to encounter Alolan Raichu in these raids, and how hard is it to shiny hunt?
You cannot control what you encounter in these things. It is entirely... Well, technically not. So, if you do a solo pathing and you have an Alolan Raichu in that pathing, if you go through the whole thing and you don't get a shiny in it, you just reset before the thing saves, and then, boom, you have a... You can just keep rechecking it over and over again. That's what we do with God Paths. And if you have the shiny charm, it is 1 in 100 for odds of getting a shiny. Your odds are 1 in 100 for that. If you don't have the shiny charm, it's 1 in 300. Wrap it up. Again, guys, if you haven't done so already, please don't forget to subscribe for more and leave a like on the stream. But yeah, no, I don't think we're ever going to get a Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee sequel. Of course they were going to switch out. The funny thing is, that's not how odds works. Do not Dynamax the Stunfisk. Do not Dynamax the Stunfisk. We need the Rotom to Dynamax because the Rotom is going to be having the most powerful move because Electro Ball is going to do crap damage to this thing. Rotom is good depending on what you're fighting. Yeah, electric types in DAs are actually kind of bad because some of them don't actually even get the benefit of electric terrain. Some of them don't even get... I mean, honestly, if it gets... Yes, Blix, we are playing with subs. We are playing with viewers and subs. That's one of the other reasons why Electro Ball is kind of garbage for fighting this thing. Because of Icy Wind and also Max Airstream. But I got Nasty Plot at least, so I can at least use that. But yeah, no, we are playing with viewers. You can't hit the... I think that Charmeleon has missed 4 out of 5 Infernos. Yeah, the subs generally do the right thing. The subs generally do exactly what like is necessary. It's the AI bots that throw. They are literally throw bots. I mean, Hex is honestly going to be stronger than Electro Ball at this point. Hex is just going to be stronger. I mean, at least I avoided that. That's actually very good. I'm probably the squishiest there is. Yeah, that's more damage than Electro Ball would have done. Oh, I outspeed it so Assurance gets damage buff. Good. Paralyze, please. Like, if we get a Paralyze, that would be ideal. Air Cutter! Honestly, I'm okay with that, because I resist that. That probably crit the Charmeleon. That didn't crit the Charmeleon. Okay, that's a little scary. That's fine. That's fine. Well, now we lose, I think. Yeah, I think we lose now. Tornado Face can suck a railroad spike. Oh, we have one more life. We've got one more life. But I don't think we win on... Oh no, now we lose. Yep, it swept us. And it swept us, of course. Yeah, if I thought to pick up the Mantine right at the start, this all could have been avoided. No shiny Stunfisk. No shiny Charmeleon. No shiny Rotom. Yeah, I think we're going to do another stream later tonight. And I think this is actually going to be all for today. If you guys haven't done so already, please don't forget to leave a like, subscribe for more. Let's go on a raid. Let's go find somebody to raid.
yeah, Game Boy's going live at 5, so that's not going to be going up for a while. Who do we raid? Who do we raid? There's a couple of people. Yeah, there's some people that, like, they've been really doing good. What's Rod doing? Yo, it's Rod's birthday stream. Okay, let's go raid Rod. Have a good day. Let's go raid Rod. Alright, but thank you guys all for tuning in. It did mean a lot seeing you guys here. Thank you all. Let's go see if we can do a redirect over to Rod. Just copy that raid tag. And I will see you all over at Rod's stream. And tonight we maybe go for some Lugia hunting. Ooh, actually, wait. Oh, Larry is doing Legends Advocates. Wait. How did I not know that? Did that not pop up in my feed? That did not pop up in my feed. Ooh. You know what? He's doing Legends Advocates. Let's go raid Larry. Let's go raid Larry. We have not raided Larry in a long time. Actually, if ever, I think. See you guys over there. Have a good night.